So back here for the Footie Show with Ian Hart and AJ Wood. Bit more about the Albion then against Everton. I mean, how would you set up against the next home game coming up? We'll talk about Chelsea separately. That's totally different kettle of fish. But next game, what's it? Leeds United, isn't it?
Yeah, Leeds. It's a tough game. I've got a lot of. He's obviously off the back of a Man City away win, not smash and grab, more like the Palace game at the Amex. But yeah, they set up well. They're a good side, and you don't really know what we're going to get with them. Obviously, it's quite clear what Graham Potter's favourite team is at the moment. It'll be Webster in, probably Veltman move to left back, and Moda on the bench.
Yeah,
that'll be the team, unless any injuries or. Any miraculous recoveries to Tarek Lamptey?
Yeah. So what we've got Leeds United, West Ham, Man City. What games do you think we'll win out of those, if any, Ian?
Potentially, we could win them all, but potentially we could lose them all.
Yeah.
But as we said, we are safe. So we're building to next year.
When you say we're safe, because people are going to be saying we're safe, 3 points. Do you think that's enough?
But look at the stats, right? West Brom and Fulham are not going to win those games. To overtake us now.
Yeah.
Fulham need 3 wins from 6 games.
Games.
Actually, probably 4 wins.
Yeah. Because of our goal difference.
Yeah, well, and that relies on Brighton just not even turning up for seven games.
It isn't going to happen. So let's, you know, put it on...
I think you're right. I mean, the bookies...
The old YouTube. Brighton are safe.
Yeah, the bookies do put Brighton 35-1 to go down, which... Pretty
really?
Odds. Yeah. So
I reckon you've put a fiver on that. You're going to all the home games.
No, you're the one that said we'd go down.
That was quite tight, yeah. But no, look, but he's going to do his forfeit, as we say, back in the day. I was more disappointed with you. And it wasn't because you're a Republican or a revolutionary. Yeah. It was because you were playing Snake on your phone. But you missed the 2-minute silence for the Duke of Edinburgh last night.
Yeah, but not everyone. I mean, obviously it was silent from standing up. But people around me didn't do it. So the guy next to me.
No, it was one person who didn't stand up next to you. And he was a Republican. Because I asked him at half-time why he didn't stand up.
Yeah.
And he says he doesn't believe in the royal family.
Oh, did he?
And I said, well, you're not welcome at the Amex.
Right, okay.